a few minutes ago in the sacristy as we were getting ready. I said to Tom, do you need to go over anything? And he said, all I know is I'm going to go out there unmarried and I'm going to leave married, right? A smart man you chose here, a smart man, right? Because the reality is, in just a few minutes, as you stand here, you're going to speak some simple words to each other, and they're going to change your lives. They're going to change your lives.
I do my best to find some kind of glow. I'm giving it some heart and soul now.
First, to each and every one of you who made your commitment of time to be with us here tonight. And we recognize the challenges of sometimes and travel plans you have to make to get here. And Karen and I are touched by the effort you made here to, you know, show your support of Tom and Christina as they begin their life together.
And by your Son's grace, Lord, you provide a way for us to be with you, Lord, in heaven at the great banquet, the big, great feast, then, Lord. We just lift up Tommy and Christina to you this day. We ask you to bless them and keep them, Lord. We ask you to bless all who are here, Lord. Bless this food. Bless this time tonight. And we ask it all in your Son's precious name. Amen.
Kind of looked at each of the different tables for Tommy, for example, and for Christina, although I don't know her family as well, but I know that, you know, I could see a table of my family, my sisters, my mother, his aunts, uncles, and things like that. I know how important they were in his life growing up and seeing them and seeing, you know, remembering Thanksgivings together and vacations together and all that. And then the people who were in Tom's life as he was growing up in our family church. Knowing that they had an impact on me and my life and helping Tommy and his siblings kind of grow spiritually. And then, you know, family, friends at other tables and seeing them and just knowing the impact that they've had in watching Tommy grow up. It really is a family celebration. You know, it's like when we started dancing, I was like, well, this is my Son's wedding. I'm going to dance early and I'm going to be out there for a long time.
It was 7.5 years ago, and I was at a very good friend's house, and we're just hanging out, and that's the night that I met her. And yesterday, if you were, any of you were at the rehearsal, Father Chris, he alluded to the fact that I was, you know, I've been dreaming of this my entire life, right? Like that night that I met her, I just kind of knew. People talk about love at first sight, and I don't like love at first sight because I think that puts a superficial feel on what it is love's about. No, I could feel it. I just knew that that was going to be my wife. 7.5 years later, that's my wife.
In addition to your parents, blessed with your grandparents, who have also witnessed to this through many years, and lots of friends who have encouraged you along the way. And so if your heart makes you ready to desire it, I invite you to come forward with your bridal party to exchange these vows.
Christina started dating Tom when she was in high school. He came to our house and he invited her to go for coffee. He seemed like a very nice gentleman.
Oh, I so look forward to this.
He seemed really funny. Every year we got to know him a little better and learn what a wonderful and gentleman he is, and kind and considered, and just so in love with my daughter, and can't ask for more than that.
And it was a trunk show at the time, and I really wasn't anticipating finding my dress. It was one of the first dresses I tried on, and I fell in love with it. I really wanted sleeves. I thought the sleeves were beautiful, and I just kind of felt like a princess, which I totally wasn't anticipating myself wanting, but I just loved it.
Christina was a very shy child, but she always had a beautiful smile.
Is it a
She was a wonderful daughter and is still a wonderful daughter, more than we could ever, ever ask for.
Oh my goodness.
What strikes me the most about Christina all the time is her smile, how she can come in and light up a room at any time. Growing up, she was also a determined child, and all maybe shy by nature, there was a certain amount of a drive in her that you knew that she was going to do well in whatever she put her mind to, and she has. And when she needs to be a leader and step up and take charge, she does. Been nothing but proud of her entire life, and just delighted for her and Tom.
Whether she's fearlessly leading our sorority, Kappa Kappa Gamma, through many of the trial and tribulations, to maintaining a long-distance relationship, which I know that can be difficult at times, but you guys do it with such grace. Christina is like the definition of sincere. She does everything with a full and open heart, and I'm sure you guys have all witnessed this or been the beneficiary of this. I know I have many, many times, and I'm very thankful for it. So Tom, you're very lucky to have someone with such a full heart. She's such a role model to us all, and she does everything with such a strong moral compass. And I think that that's brought you to where you are now, and it will most certainly guide you guys together as you build your new life together.
I shoot the boxes. Do you like them?
Yeah.
I know this
fits. It's game time.
Growing up, you know, I've spent the past 23 and a half years, you know, watching him grow up, and it's been an honor. And one thing, you know, you can say about him, he's a leader. And he's always led. And, you know, for me, the little brother, to look up to him, it's been great to see him grow up and turn to this Marine that I've bragged about through high school and college.
You don't have the steady hands or the know how to pull off a procedure like that. Drive across the plains,
make my way up north. He changed and he's turned into a great guy, and I think it's a lot to do with you, Christina. So if we can all raise a glass to the bride and groom, thank you. I love you guys, and here's a long and happy marriage.
Dear Thomas John, today is the day. There are no tomorrows, and I couldn't be happier. While we have been planning for this day for a year and a half, thinking of the 7.5 years, I've been dreaming of this day since I was a little girl. I dreamed of the perfect dress, flowers, venue, and most importantly, the perfect husband. I prayed I would not only marry a man who would love and protect me, but a man that was my best friend. You were not only my best friend, but you are truly my other half. I'm so excited to be your wife and call you my husband. From this day forward, we have officially started our own little family. I'm so excited to see what life has in store for us, and I'm even more excited we can conquer it together. I love you, Thomas John. See you at the altar. Love, Christina.
To watch Christina walk down the aisle. I just couldn't wait to see how beautiful she was going to look. But I watched Tommy most of the time watching her and just seeing how he was so focused. And we were making bets how long it would be before he cried. And, you know, would my big, tough Marine cry? And they just look deep into each other's eyes. And that was very memorable for me. I love to see that. I love to see him watch her.
A defining moment for their wedding was probably when Christina was coming down the aisle and everybody was looking at her, and I was looking at Tom, and he was getting kind of emotional, and I knew that at my wedding Tom did the same thing to me. Together, together, two birds of a feather. just by the way he was looking, you could start getting a little choked up. Like he loves this girl, and I was watching that, and I couldn't be more happy for them.
People love them. Like, to see Christina's parents specifically, she's the apple of their eye. They adore her, and they've loved her. It's really nice to see that, and it's really nice to see them embrace Tommy as, you know, part of their family.
And a little over 6 years ago, I met Christina, and shortly after, I met Tom. And the first thing you notice about them is that not only do they share such a great love, but they're such great friends. And I think that that's why they've been able to last so long and to have such a beautiful relationship and now marriage is because they have such a strong friendship at the core.
It's certainly a most gorgeous day as the two of them come to unite themselves in the bond of holy marriage. Much preparation has gone into this, and they rejoice in you, their family and friends who can come with them to this place. Now, how many of you knew this wonderful couple when they were in high school? Show of hands. All right, so you knew them when they met each other. Who remembers that change of scenery, right? Now, how many of you knew at that point that we would be here today so many years later? Anyone? Eric, you're claiming that? All right, you guys are the brother, right? All right. Well, I'm not sure if they did. They might be lying already, right, in church, no less, right? But certainly God knew. God knew.
I absolutely knew that Tom and Christina were going to be getting married because Tom told me he was going to marry her. It was Bill, Christina's other brother, his wedding with Katie. And we were just kind of talking about family and random things, and he looked at me and he said, "I'm going to marry your sister-in-law." And I looked at him and just smiled. I was like, "Really?" He goes, "Oh yes, I'm going to marry Christina." And so I knew this day was going to come.
Christina and Thomas, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes. Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes. Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into this marriage, I invite you to join your right hands and declare your consent before God and the church.
I, Thomas,
take you, Christina.
Take you, Christina,
to be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Hi, Christina.
Hi, Christina.
Take you, Thomas.
Take you, Thomas.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Christina, take this ring.
Christina, take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Thomas, take this ring.
Thomas, take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
And you seal your love with a kiss. God bless.
I think a moment that definitely got emotional for me and it kind of summed up today was after Christina and Tom had said their vows and we were getting towards the end of the Mass and they had gone over to the Blessed Mother and he just got all filled up just standing there looking at Christina and I could tell, like, you know, they have wedding day nerves and all that stuff. They've gone through this long distance relationship. So I think looking at each other and he could look at her after all these years and realize it all kind of sunk into him. So having a view of him as he filled up looking at Christina after pretty much the ceremony was done was definitely the best part of today.
Please join me again in congratulating First Lieutenant and Mrs. Thomas Hemer.
This is their one wedding, and I know this. It wasn't just for Christina and Tom. It was really for the whole family, and their family is so close. That I know really important to them was that everybody was really a part of today, not just by showing up today, but from the beginning, part of the engagement process, and then part of today, and then hopefully part of whatever is to come.
Christina is so supporting. She's got such a great heart. And Tom is just so lively and just wants to take the world by storm.
Seven and a half years ago, I met two very wonderful Levis girls. And of course, Christina Marie is one of them. And the other one is Mrs. Levis. So, you know, I know for a while there may have been some concern that, gosh, am I gonna lose a daughter for this thing? I assure you, you did not lose a daughter to marriage today. You just gained a son. And I'm gonna work hard to make sure I'm doing that as best as possible. You've also gained a 24/7, 365 days a year bodyguard to your one little daughter over there. So the next group of people I gotta pay my respects to for being here is those that wear the uniform that I'm currently wearing. You know, it started at Penn State University, where I met some of the finest young men and women that I could possibly think to serve with, and all the support that we've received from you guys over the years. Thanks for welcoming Christina to the fold. Semper Fi. So the second to last group of people that I would like to thank are, of course, my parents. A couple weeks ago, no, I guess it was about 10 days ago, my mom sent me a text message, and you know, I opened it up and I read it, and it was like, hey, did you get a package in the mail today? Because you're gonna be getting somebody. And I was like, no, but I was really excited because I love care packages, it's really awesome. But this one was even better. So apparently my mom has written a diary for all of her children growing up. But up until about 10 days ago, what I received in the mail was a copy of that diary. I said it, and I know I can speak on behalf of myself and Christina when I say that. I think no matter how grown up you feel you got, you know, no matter how you know much you've done in life, you tend to forget. But the reality is, you are always somebody's little boy, somebody's little girl. And I know that the support that we've received from both sides of this family here growing up has just been amazing.
Christina and Tom, first and foremost, are extremely family-oriented. Anytime they get to spend together, they always make sure they spend it with the whole Levis family, the whole Hemer family, their nieces and nephews. They've always just kind of been very accommodating and understanding of kind of everybody's situation and how everybody feels about them. And they've sacrificed a lot of their together time to be with everybody. And just seeing them kind of grow as friends and as a couple, that's been definitely part of their dynamic together.
As they were cutting the cake, they had Tommy's, you know, military sword, his Marine sword, and he had her kind of underneath him, and he was kind of guiding it through the cake, and they were like both intently focused on and everything. And I was just kind of watching him, and I was just thinking, wow, that's husband and wife there. I mean, that was the moment that it hit me. So in all of the fanfare and everything, it was just in that little simple moment, it just like went, boink, hit me in the head. And it was a good feeling. It was really, it brought a smile to my face.
First of all, I want to say thank you to everyone who's come. And today was such a wonderful and beautiful day. And our hope for you too is many, many, many more wonderful and beautiful days to come. So if you would like to join me, to Christina and Tom, our beautiful princess, and our very handsome and debonair prince, May they truly live happily ever after. To Christina and Tom.
God's plan for you to be truly happy, the way you're going to be the woman that God made you to be. Look to your left. Tom, you need to look to your right.
Don't mess up his hair. Wrap your arms around him and mess him with him a little bit.
We're not good.
At a Kappa event, I would lead you guys in a cheer that goes something like, take a shot, take a shot, take a shot, get Kappa can. But we're at a fancy event, so I'm just going to say, please raise your glass and join me in toasting Christina and Tom. Something beautiful is most definitely on the horizon.